Hey there, Himanshu Dama here from iTech, and today I'm very excited to share this really cool tutorial with you all. I will be showing you how to run the latest Android L operating system on your PC or laptop. So let's go ahead and open your browser and search for Android SDK. Now download the Android SDK Manager for Windows. Accept the terms and conditions and select the suitable version for your OS. That is 32-bit or 64-bit. You can find your OS architecture in your computer's properties. The file size is 350 MB, and it will take some time to download. Meanwhile, install the Java if you haven't installed it already. The Java has been successfully installed, and my Android SDK download is also complete. Now extract the download file to desktop, or anywhere else where you find it easy to reach. Now go ahead and open up the folder and run the Android SDK Manager tool. First, it will fetch the list of available SDK from the server. Once the list is fetched, choose as packages to install. You can also install other Android versions too, by choosing the suitable version packages. In extra section, it is recommend to select all. After you have finished selecting packages, then go ahead and click install packages, and now you will get license agreement dialog box, so you can accept the software license for the Android development. Now it will download the selected packages. It will take some time depending on your internet speed. My download is completed, and now create an Android virtual device. Go to Tools menu at the top, and click Manage AVDs, and create a new Android device. Name your device, don't use space or any other special characters, choose your device as Nexus 5 or 7, select target as Android L. Select your CPU as Intel Atom, choose your skin, I will go with no skin, and for RAM. Minimum requirement is 512 MB, but I recommend 768 or 1024 MB. Give your virtual device 1024 or 2048 MB of storage, and check use host GPU. And when your device is successfully created, all you have to do is just go ahead and start your Android device. It will take 4 to 5 minutes for the first time boot, so be patient. And now I'm gonna go ahead and start from where it actually loaded. So I have now got a working Android L emulator on my PC, and you can easily make it on your own PC just the way I've done. And yeah, I hope this has been helpful. I hope you really enjoyed this, and I look forward to know what you guys are doing with the Android L emulator once you have successfully installed it. And if you face any errors while installing Android L on your PC, then write down in comments. I will provide you the solution as soon as possible. So again, thank you for watching this video. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my tech channel if you haven't already. Thank you.